fact that for the first time in 30 years, you couldn't even buy a beer in Washington. The civil rights marchers needed no stimulants like that. They provided their own with songs that ranged from the sacred to the hillbilly, but with the one recurring theme, the cause of 20 million Negroes.
We've reached a point, I think, in society where we can no longer depend on the intrinsic motivations of people to move society forward. The men who organized the rally... Where intrinsic motivation has gotten us is the world today. Burning fossil fuels, unable to stop, fishing the oceans to extinction, people being overweight, the government at a standstill. This is because we don't have a good understanding in systems design of what motivates and drives people.
We spend 3 billion hours a week playing online games. I believe that if we want to survive the next century on this planet, we need to increase that total dramatically. I've calculated the total we need at 21 billion hours of gameplay every week.
I'm gonna give you a lowdown, a gamification.
A new model for improving the experiences that make up our lives.
I'm gonna give you a lowdown, a gamification. I'm gonna give you a lowdown, a gamification.
Gamification is the use of game thinking and game mechanics to engage people and solve problems.
Let's see how it works.
Really, the way it works is by leveraging human desires. We're all pretty basic.
They believe that people actually behave in the way described by the simplified economic model. Performance targets and incentives would be set for everything and everyone.
Yeah, my personal belief is that, the gamification of life is truly going to happen.
Automated incentives and messaging to get them to do more of what you want them to do.
Wouldn't you like to have that kind of dedication from a $60,000 per year employee? Well, now you can.
Innovation plus gamification equals motivation.
See how you can position yourself as the answer to the fears and needs of your clients.
Gabe Zickerman, entrepreneur and author of the book, Game-Based Marketing.
Burning fossil fuels, unable to stop, fishing the oceans to extinction, people being overweight, the government at a standstill.
Malnutrition.
Diarrhea. Pneumonia.
And malaria.
Who do you think is designing these games? Skilled game designers? No, not really. Just like whoever's there is doing it.
Do what makes money. Do more of what makes money and less of what doesn't.
What this is all about is really solving one of the major problems that marketing consultants have.
Thank you for joining me as we continue on with this 7-part series entitled, How Your Business Can Survive and Prosper in the Recession.
Hello, people.
Before one of the biggest things is establishing some type of credibility.
How's life on Earth?
Be an information hub. Be a one-stop shop for news and knowledge relevant to your industry. Start a blog with tips and tricks for success and share valuable info on Twitter, Facebook, and in LinkedIn forums.
And we at Chic.tv have your guide to navigating the top 5 fashion trends of 2011. And at number 1 in 2011,
gamification, an entire new business paradigm is about to turn the world upside down.
Looks great with jeans or paired with a bohemian dress for a fun contrast. If you're not feeling the totally monochromatic look, try adding a bright accessory for a fun pop of color.
People want the downfall of the regime. For them, the much-hated past is still present. That is why Friday's protest was dubbed...
Yes, the old system encouraged many negative things, and they had no soma to ease the pain.
A broken heart will fall apart when left alone to grieve. To ease the pain and hide the shame, you'll live in make-believe. The tears you'll hide, but deep inside, the torture will remain. There's no mistake, the drink you take is just to ease the pain.
Share information offline by speaking at an industry event or conference.
I've calculated the total we need at 21 billion hours of gameplay every week. So. That's probably a bit of a counterintuitive idea, so I'll say it again, let it. I've calculated the total we need at 21 billion hours of gameplay every week.
But the move has prompted a general strike from the unions. Public transport has been disrupted, and air traffic controllers are staging a partial walkout.
The reality is, sometimes...
In a country now facing record unemployment of 27%, closure has prompted yet more dismay.
The game subsumes the intrinsic action activity. It just eats it, because it's more important, it's more compelling.
And that's what gamification is all about.
And I hope these techniques will help you work on the crisis, look on the crisis, I mean, as an opportunity.
How's life on Earth?